all-pervading love, wisdom, and power, we pray that we may become increasingly aware of the glory of the spiritual life. We aspire to greater knowledge and wisdom through deeper humility of spirit and await the incoming of thy light, which reveals the wonders of the universe. Unite all these, thy children, in a common love and sympathy, and may all arrogant and critical thoughts be laid aside. May we stand together as children of thine, seeking through communion of spirit the greater wisdom of life. Amen.
We bring the light from the main altar to the central altar to represent that flame which is present within each one of us. May we strive to keep it bright and shining and help us in our service to our brothers. Would you please join me in the Lodge Invocation? May the light of our hearts shine in my heart. Stand guard over my thoughts and guide my speech and actions into ways of service. May the light of Christ shine from
This is our world healing prayer. We remember the great need of our world, and we seek to still our mind so that we come into a place of peace and deep stillness, drawing closer to God in prayer. Let us open our hearts to the power, love, and wisdom of God. By the Christ light and love in our hearts, we call to the great angels of the Christ star circle. Being still, we feel their presence and their power. And now with all the will of our minds, with all the love of our deepest hearts, we send forth the light. We send it forth as a great star of light, a blazing star, a star of the Christ light, lifting all hearts into the eternal heart of God. By all the power of Christ within our hearts, we send forth the light to the world. We hold our beautiful planet in the healing light of the Christ star. We hold within this healing ray the soil, the waters of the earth and the air, and all nature, especially the human and animal kingdoms. And today we hold the thought atmosphere worldwide in the light. We hold in the heart of the Christ star the soul of the Americas, the soul of the people of the Americas. May the light of the Christ star shine through the hearts and minds of the people of the Americas to bring healing to mankind and reverence for all life. Let us hold within this great healing star anyone known to us personally who is in need of help or healing. And silently we name them now, and we see them radiant within this beautiful healing light. Amen.
our healing circle. Let us open our hearts to the Christ power, wisdom, and love, as together we call upon the angels of healing to draw close. We come into the soft radiance of this love as we focus and hold the healing light of the Christ star over our world at this time. With hearts full of love and gratitude, we give our grateful thanks. Amen. Susan has chosen as a reading this morning a portion from White Eagle's book, Seeking Serenity.
Well, could you just speak a little louder?
Speak a little loud. Oh, there we go. Can you hear me now?
Yes, thank you.
I apologize. Do we do the healing circle again? No? Okay. It's always hard because then you can't see what you're trying to read. Okay, so Susan has for her reading this morning, it's from the White Eagle's book, Seeking Serenity. Now I feel like I'm yelling. Okay, relax while we are in our stillness. Take your thoughts to your higher spiritual self. Oh, now I'm all verklempt. Sorry. Which knows that fear is unnecessary. Nothing happens by chance. If you live tranquilly, patiently, always with this consciousness of God's love behind you and through you, you will find that whatever has crept in and seemingly spoiled your life will gradually be resolved if you just take your hands off and keep quiet. Be still and let God work his or her will. All will be perfectly harmonious. All will be peaceful and will work together. Greater work is being done on your earth than you know with your earthly mind. There is a mighty increase of spiritual power and an awakening of the Christ light in the hearts of many, many people. We ask you to create in your mind the image of a perfect world, a perfect land. The way for you to restore the true way of life on this planet, to restore harmony and brotherhood, is to hold humanity and indeed the earth itself in a perfect thought, a thought of harmony, of brotherly love and wholeness or healthiness. If a person of peace enters a noisy room where others are speaking in loud voices and indulging in argument and dissension, with a very few words, he or she can restore peace and quietude in the company. This, my brethren, you need to do on earth. Do not add fuel to fire by discussing the wars and future wars. Do not look into the future with fear. Have no part in conversation about fear and destruction. See the nations being drawn together in brotherhood. Know that this is to be, because this is the divine will. In spiritual law, there can be no compromise and no excuse. Law is law, and spiritual law is the law of brotherhood and love and tranquility. See the nations walking together as brothers in the sunlight. This is the way to restore the peace on earth. A long time has passed, my children, since you left that heavenly home, that world of sunlight, the spiritual sun from which you all originated. And so you forget that you are spirit, born of God, and eternally linked with God. You have to learn consciously to remember that you are a part of this eternal spiritual sun. Light will shine on your life and your fears will dissolve. You will discover later on that your cloud has a silver lining. and you will find completion, happiness, service. If you have to cross a bridge, you will have a very wise and strong companion by your side, holding your hand, crossing the bridge with you. In time, you will find great power welling up within. Put your hand out to God. He, she will clasp your hand and draw you up. God is within your innermost being. And if you will train yourself to realize this, that you are the point within the circle, God, that you are the point within the blazing star, then you will find peace, deep peace, in your heart. You will be still, at rest. You will know divine love. All your thoughts and speech and actions will be spontaneously directed from the heart of divine love. Live in the unwavering consciousness that with God, good love, all things are possible. God holds the power for you, and every experience is to bring you right into the heart of God's love. This is your goal, and the happenings on earth are all stepping stones leading you to your goal. God holds the key. It is light. It is the star of God within you. The star, which is based on divine love, is the creator of the perfect light, and all humanity will in time achieve the object, the goal of their life, which is to be fully conscious of life within this blazing star. Remember the shining star brotherhood, that great multitude in the heavens, the brotherhood of the light. They know no darkness, no doubt or fear. They know that all is moving forward to ultimate brotherhood. All the good, the true, and the beautiful things on your earth are inspired and guided and brought into manifestation by the true brotherhood, the brotherhood of the star. Try to expand in consciousness and realize the immensity of that great star brotherhood. You live confined in your physical bodies, which are like little closed boxes. But if you will, by aspiration and inspiration, strive to reach that vast brotherhood, you will receive the greatest good. Try to become en rapport with that ancient and limitless brotherhood of life. One day, every person will recognize that shining presence with him or her and will become that blazing star. Keep your vision on the star, brethren. A flood of heavenly light is poured upon you now. May you be caught up in this glory of the eternal light, the very life of God. Amen.
Greetings of
First, I'm going to make sure you can hear me okay.
Yes.
Good? It's not too loud. Okay. So, in case you can't guess what I'm going to talk about based on that song, my topic that I chose today, I want to talk about our six-pointed star, the Star of Light. And I know many of you already know many things that I'll be speaking about today, but sometimes when we see something so many times, we don't always see it anymore. It becomes so familiar. So we've got this beautiful star above us. We've got stars up here. Everything we send out from the lodge, the logo, is the six-pointed star. And sometimes I just don't see it. And so I thought I'm going to focus on it because, in particular, during this time period, I think it's crucial and quite helpful. So just to go into a little bit about the history or the meaning, the symbol itself is, as you know, quite ancient. And I'm going to take some words from White Eagle. He says, the lower triangle represents the lower aspect of man, aspiring to heaven or to God. The higher is the descent of the three, wisdom, love, and power, which interpenetrates the lower or matter. So it's spirit interpenetrating matter. So is formed the double triangle or the Solomon seal. However, with our stars, you notice you can't see any of the lines. It's just all a complete star. And that has to do with, again, it's that interpenetration of God and man or matter. And when that is realized, we gain poise and self-mastery. And White Eagle says it can also be discerned as a symbol of power. And one little sort of sidebar that I found interesting, he says, one can also read in this symbol 7 points, for whilst there are 6 outer points to the star, the 7th point is the center. And he says, so again, we go more deeply and discern the symbol of the 7 great spirits round the throne, the 7 great ones who guide humanity from within. Indeed, in that six-pointed star, we may read the blazing glory of the grand geometrician of the universe. So here we have sacred geometry in all its glory. So if you're familiar with the Sphinx in Egypt, you know, with the head and the body, that is the same idea, because that represents the head of the perfect human growing out of the animal body. Ancient symbol. And so people may say, well, why has this symbol been chosen for this lodge? And White Eagle says to that, the star with the 6 points represents the star of light, of brotherhood, the star of Christ. It was the star which led the wise men of the East to the humble stable, or we might say the cave, the heart cave, wherein was born and is being born the Christ child. So with the star representing this Christ love, when you visualize inwardly the star, you are tuning in to the Christ energy. It's that pure white light that you can just tap into anytime, and you will be showered with the love of God. And when we say, I always kind of look, okay, what does that mean? What does that mean? What does that mean? But when we say the star symbolizes the Christ, what do we mean by that? We mean the Christ love. This is from White Eagle. The star then represents the Christ love, the love to which Jesus of Nazareth referred when he said, love one another. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and all thy soul and all thy mind, and as thy neighbor as thyself. The love of Christ is represented by this star. So we have in that symbol a representation of ancient wisdom and the love of Christ, the wisdom and love combined, which is to be realized by humanity in this new age, the age of Aquarius. So sort of on a practical level here too, I know we're all working with our thoughts all the time, and so the star is a wonderful place to focus, even more so given the climate of our days. We're all dealing with personal issues, global issues, you name it. And a friend reminded me, though, that we have down through the ages have always had earthly cares and concerns to deal with. In a sense, what we are facing is a big one, but it's just one more on the rung of evolution of humanity. And Joan Hodgson, daughter of Grace Cook, you know, I'm sure you're all familiar with her, she said the shining six-pointed star is the most compelling focal point for thought. When you are downtrodden, confused, if you visualize the star, it can lift you out of that fog and despondency that so often accompanies earth life. So it can really help us control these thoughts. It's right there, just go. She also said the thought of the star is wonderfully helpful at times when we are shocked, if we're upset, deeply hurt, or full of fear, either for ourselves or for our loved ones. The sad thoughts, the fear thoughts, the anger thoughts, they go round and round and round in the brain until we become distraught. But if immediately the shock hits us, we turn our thoughts to that star and focus all our concentration on its strength, peace, beauty, we soon begin to feel enveloped in a beautiful cocoon, protective cocoon of light. I was out walking about, I walk a lot these days, and about a week ago I was taking a long walk and I started to feel very down and despondent, almost a sense of despair. I wasn't sure where this all was coming from, my thoughts, someone else's thoughts, whatever it is, I was ruminating. And so I said, Susan, okay, let's go to the star. So I did. I focused on the star as I walked. I was saying this to Jane the other day, it takes like 10, 12 minutes, and I finally lifted myself out of that. By the time I got home, I was okay, and I couldn't even quite remember what exactly had been bothering me. So it's a pretty cool thing to do, really helpful. One thing to be aware of is when we're focusing on the star, this vision, so we're opening that third eye, and so we're taking our energy out of the lower chakras. Oftentimes we will gather certainly our own thoughts, but the thoughts of others, whatever's going on in the world, lower solar plexus is often a place where things enter. And so as you visualize the star, you're moving your energy up your system and you are opening the third eye, you're developing that, and you pull yourself out of that. Oh, and Wayne Dole, I love that he says this in many different ways in many different places, but he said, don't strain. So if you're going to focus on the star, other things, he said, just do it very gently, easily, and it will become easier and easier as we remember to use it more often. A great practice is to visualize the star before you go to sleep, just above you, and there you go. And one thing I did want to bring in is a little bit about what we call the star circle or the Christ circle. And White Eagle said this is a circle that consists of angelic beings, evolved humans, spiritual beings with the mark of the six-pointed star on their forehead. And they want to work with us. So when we open the door to them, to this Christ energy, then they can come very close to help men and women, which is the opening of the door into a radiant and glorious world, not only in higher spheres, but here also. It is true that the earth has made a great advance towards beauty and harmony during the past great cycle of life, which is, as you know, roughly 25,000 years. And those of you who fear that the new age of Aquarius, being a mental age, will bring great ills to the world should remember that this also brings a great spiritual outpouring. And do not think that the new age will be that of the mind unbalanced by the waters of the spirit. There is to be an outpouring of spiritual power and spiritual sustenance together with development of the mental state. And when you get the combination of the two, you get divine intelligence. And then mankind will be able to comprehend universal truth. Then he will be able to throw wide open the door of his heart and of his mind to those visitors from the Christ circle. The star circle. They really want to work with us. We can call on them at any time. So, in closing, just simply remember to visualize the star at any time you feel the need when you remember to do so. soul. White Eagle says to attune to the star at the magical hours of 3, 6, 9, and 12. In tuning in, you not only clear and uplift yourself, you assist the entire planet, this is part of our service work, in the realization of the Christ love. This is a statement I'm sure many of you have heard before, but the positive God thought of one person has greater power than the negative thoughts of thousands on the same subject. So you think about all the power that we have just with our thoughts. And I feel this is so important because, yes, we're tuning to the star, we're tuning to the light, we're raising ourselves up. Okay, we got it. And then we want to spread it out. Then we want to send the light out from that point. And then we are being true servants of the great light. So I did leave some postcards out on the table as you exit. They're just a beautiful little postcard of the star. So if you don't have one, please take that. You can have that for yourself as a reminder. I have a few stars all over my home. I'm going to do communion, but I just wanted to make a little announcement. After communion, we will play a song that's written by one of our members. His name is John McKenna. He's currently residing in Florida, and he's a singer-songwriter. And the song is called Lean a Little Closer. And John relates that it was given to him by an angel. And so as you listen to Lean a Little Closer, just think of an angel kind of conveying this information to you. It's quite lovely. So we'll come together now for our communion. Dearly loved brethren, think daily of the star circle, of the great company of angels and archangels and illumined human beings, masters of the wisdom and masters of the love, who come to humanity's assistance. Every soul which is ready to respond to this tremendous yet simple and gentle ray of the Christ love will be made use of by the star circle for the salvation and advancement of humanity. From the heart, the rays of the Christ love are distributed to humanity, to all the forces invisible concerned with the evolution of humanity. We meditate on the star circle which is working for peace on earth. And do your part to help the angels. Although you may feel you are obscure, your light must add to the glory of the heavenly light of the star. The spiritual unfoldment of humanity, the unfoldment of true vision, powers of the Spirit, will come to all men and women who prove receptive to the Christ light, and to all who will give forth the spirit of brotherhood and peace. So we receive these amazing, brilliant white, gold, silver rays of the star upon our being. Our cups are filled with this wonderful nectar of the light, which we can take into our system for revitalization, upliftment, and love. So may every soul be present, every soul present, be receptive to the rays of the Christ star and the peace of the eternal love.